गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड
ओके, सो आफ्टरनून। ओके, सो लास्ट टाइम यस्टरडे वी हैड डन गूगल माय बिजनेस, राइट?
यस
ओके, सो टुडे वी वुड बी डूइंग गूगल एनालिटिक्स। सो गूगल एनालिटिक्स इज फॉर गेटिंग ऑल द एनालिटिक्स ऑफ द वेबसाइट। सो यस, दिस इज एनालिटिक्स। सो गूगल एनालिटिक्स इज अ वेब एनालिटिक्स सर्विस ऑफर्ड बाई गूगल दैट ट्रैक्स एंड रिपोर्ट्स वेबसाइट ट्रैफिक। सो बेसिकली वी गेट ऑल द इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द ट्रैफिक दैट वी आर गोइंग टू गेट ऑन आवर वेबसाइट। सो इट कुड बी वेबसाइट, ब्लॉग, और से इवन यूट्यूब और एनी अदर थिंग। इट कैन बी इवन ब्लॉग्स। सो वेर एवर वी आर गेटिंग ट्रैफिक, वी कैन इंटीग्रेट गूगल एनालिटिक्स एंड वी कैन गेट ऑल द रिपोर्ट्स विथ विच वी कैन एनहैंस आवर वेबसाइट। सो आई क्लिक ऑन गूगल एनालिटिक्स एंड वी विल कम टू द पेज। ओके, सो नाउ सिंस आई एम लॉग्ड इन, यू आई एम गेटिंग दिस पेज। अदरवाइज वॉट वी हैव टू डू इज आई क्लिक ऑन एडमिन ओवर हियर। आई हैव द फर्स्ट थिंग, दिस पेज वुड कम अप एंड वी हैव टू क्लिक ऑन क्रिएट अकाउंट। सो इन क्रिएटिंग अकाउंट आई विल बी जस्ट प्रोवाइडिंग द नेम ऑफ द अकाउंट। सो जस्ट दिस इज जस्ट इन केस इफ आई एम हैविंग मल्टीपल अकाउंट्स। सो आई विल जस्ट राइट वन ऑफ माई नेम over here, say like I can provide my name that okay Hitesh, and then I will go to the next field. I'll keep all these things checked, so you agree to terms and conditions and everything, so other things are applicable. And then we'll tell Google that from where do we want to measure the website traffic. So whether it is a website or app, so app can be Android app or iOS app, or we want to say that okay fine, we want to track from both the places, so that also we can do. So I have selected website, so I'll click website and then I'll click on next. And then over here I need to write the name of my website, so I'll say Earth Rebooted, and then I need to provide the URL of my website, so it's HTTPS and then the website URL. Okay, so this is the website URL we have added. Then I need to select the category, so whatever is the nearest possible category which you can find over here that I can enter. So I would select okay education. Okay, jobs and education is mentioned, so I'll select jobs and education. Then reporting time, what is the our reporting time, so I would select India over here. So I'll click OK and then I'll click on create. So automatically this page will comes up wherein I need to select my country to accept the terms and conditions. So these are all the terms and conditions, so I just need to check that okay fine, I accept data processing terms and conditions related to GDPR. And then Google Measurement Controller Data Protection Terms and Conditions, so that also I need to check. And then I'll click on Accept. I accept, and then it will provide me the tracking code which I need to add on my website. So this is the tracking code. So this whole thing is the tracking code. So what I can do is I can just copy this code and I'll paste it over here. And just in case if I am not using any WordPress website or any content management system besides WordPress or anything else, then in that case I can paste this code in my website. So once I paste this code in my website, I will start to get all the data in Google Analytics. So Google will get all the information, Google will track all the information for the visitors they are coming on my website, and then we will get a detailed report. So now how do we add this code? So I just need to go to the website. So I'll just type okay, I don't think I've installed WordPress in this website, so I'll just go to another website and check over there. So I'll log into this website and I'll enter my username and password, that is my WordPress. So I'm logged in. So for this, first of all, what I need a plugin. So I will click on add new plugin, and then over here in keywords, what I'll do is I'll say Google Analytics. So then it will search for the plugin Google Analytics. So there are various plugins available which I can use, and you can just check the reviews what are there. So if I want, the best thing is provided, see, you can see these all plugins are provided by other people. So the best thing is I will install this plugin. This is Sitekit by Google, so which has all the applications from Google. So I'll just install this from Google. So this also has Google Analytics, so I'll just click on install now. So this has Google Analytics, it has AdSense, then Google My Business, everything is there. So I'll just click on activate, and now we need to start the setup. So I'll click on start setup and sign in with Google. So then I need to tell Google with what account did I sign in. So over here, whichever account, whichever Gmail address I have signed up with, logged in with, so I need to provide that email address over here. I'll select that email address and click allow, and then it will authenticate our username and password, and then the connection process will start. So I need to say allow. So allow my blog to access Google account, so it will access my account. So now I can say go to my dashboard. So now it will again take us back to WordPress website where I can make connections to whatever I want. So over here I can see Google dashboard. So we are on Google dashboard, and in this Google dashboard we can see various options available, wherein we can see search console is there, then other things are also there, say activated page speed insights. So everything is activated over here. So as such I don't need to do anything, but I just need to know whether everything is connected, whether Google this analytics is connected or not. So I just go to settings and I'll just check. So this is search console is connected, so connect more services. So I'll click on connect more services, and over here we can see analytics. See, so now I will click on setup analytics. So once I click on setup analytics, it will again ask me the same email address. So I'll log in with the same email address and follow the same process which we had done earlier. So I'll click on allow, and then it is checking whether we have a property added in Google Analytics or not. So over here it is asking me, so this is my account. And over here I just need to check, see, okay, over here we do not have that option, so I need to set up a new account. So over here I need to tell that, okay, this is my website URL, this is my account. So account, I can tell them that, okay, fine, this is my account website, Digital Lake Media. and then I what view I want, so I want all website data, so that is fine. And then I say create account. So that account should be created over here in Google Analytics. So okay, so allow. So other option over here, what we need to do is the same process which we followed in Google Analytics, the same process we can do. So I'll show you from there also. So if you do not want to create from here, then you can create directly from Analytics, but usually this is an easy process, so we are doing it from here, but I'll also show you how to do it from Analytics. The procedure that we just followed on Analytics is the same thing. See now Google Analytics over here, Earth rebooted, that all things is coming up. So I just need to tell that what property I am looking for. Okay, this is this. Okay, under Helpopedia. Okay, I do not have this. So what I need to do is I need to create one more account. So for this reason, what I will do is first of all, I'll just accept the terms and conditions over here. Okay, but this is not the website. So what I need to do is I again need to go back over here. I'll first of all, I just select this. Or else what I will do is I'll keep this on hold and I'll go to Google Analytics, and over here I can create a property. So what for that, what I'll do is I'll go to admin. And I will add the property, because the website for which I want to track, that website should be under Analytics. So the first thing I need to go to Analytics and add the website. See, yesterday we had added the website in Search Console. We had added the domain URL, and then we had downloaded a file, and then we had uploaded that file on server, and then click on verify property. So now the same process will be done over here. So I'll add one more. So I'll go to admin, and over here I will select the account under which I want. So I'll select I can even select whatever name, so under which name, so it's just a top name under which my properties will come. So I'll select Hitesh, and over here I need to create a new property. So I'll say create a new property, then I'll again say that okay fine, this is the web, it is a website, then I'll say continue. And then I need to tell what is the name of my website. So this is the process of adding a new website in Google Analytics. So I'll say that okay fine, this website is Digital Lake Media. This is the name of the website, and then I need to tell the URL. So I'll say URL. Oops. digitallakemedia.in, then I'll select a category. So category I can write anything, whatever is the nearest. So okay, computers and accessories, finance, healthcare, hobbies, internet. Okay, so I mean I'm not getting the category, so I'll just write shopping. So this would be a shopping kind of website or something else, I don't know. Okay, I'll select something else. Okay, there is nothing related to education. So for time being, what I will do is I'll select any of the category which is available over here. So I'll just say jobs and education, or say I'll just say news or online community. So I'll just select one nearest category, then I'll select the country, so India, and then I'll say create. So now my property will be created. This is the property which is already created. So now this is the tracking code, and now this is the code for this particular website, Digital Lake Media, which we can see over here. So now I will just refresh this page. And then I will see over here, now Digital Lake Media is coming up, right? So I'll select Digital Lake Media and all website data, and then I'll select India. So this is the integration, say this page is of from my website which came up over here. So I accept and I accept, and then I click on I accept. So now it is done. So it says that it is success, your analytic account was successfully created, go to my dashboard. So it will take me back to my website. So you can see over here analytics is connected and search console is also connected. Now later on if I want, I can connect my page speed insight also and AdSense account also, so that we will connect later on. So right now analytics is connected and now I will start to get data in another 2 to 3 days. Google will take approximately 2 to 3 days to start getting all the data from my website. So this is what we can see over here. And now the most important thing that I need to do is I need to go to home, and now I can check all the data from whatever it is gathering from my website. But right now on this website, we have, since we have just added, I cannot show you any data because there is no data. You can see everything is 00. So for that reason, what I will do is I will go to my website where all the details are there. What happened, my website over here, yes, Helpopedia is there, and over here all website data is there. So now it will switch and now it will show the data from Helpopedia. Yeah, so now over here you can see 144 users, revenue is 0, conversion rate is 0, sessions 128. It will show that okay, from this period, say 227.3% has increased, then 249% of sessions have increased. So session is basically whenever you open a browser, open a website and then you close it, that is called one session. So whenever you open a new tab over here, now you enter a URL and then you browse the website and then you close this tab, so that is one session. So that was one session, so that is all sessions. So out of 178 sessions, 144 users were there. So that is what over here we can see all the bird's eye view of the dashboard of the most important information that we just want to see over here. So I can just see how do you acquire users. So Google will tell us that your website is getting direct users and organic users. So this is organic users. We can see that there were 5 organic searches on Google and direct 74 people came. So that is what they say, and on which dates they have come, that we can see on each and every day. We can see the number of traffic and number of people coming to our website. And this is a small graph of about the active users trending over time. So on different days and time the people are coming, in how many days people are coming, that is what we can see over here. And this is the retention, that is the retention of users per week, say from week 0, week 1, week 2, week 3, week 4, week 5, like that we can see. And these are the dates. So here this information is provided. And then over here, when do your users visit? So here whatever we see, the most darkest part, that is the highest number of people coming, and the whatever is the lightest part, that is the less number of people coming, and whatever is gray part means that people did not come to our website and on that day. So now over here we can see time on the right hand side vertically. We can see the time, at what time did people come, and over here we are seeing the days of the week. So Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, like this we can see. So if I want to see Sunday, and over here I can see this. So this person came between, say it came at 1 o'clock. So over here it is 12, then it is 1, then this is 2, then this is 3 o'clock, then 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock. So like this alternative numbers are provided. So in between number is 3. So over here the between number is 1. So this is at 1 a.m. In the night time the person has come up. Then again someone came at around this is 12 p.m. and then we can see someone came at 3 p.m. then 4 p.m. 5 p.m. like this we can see at on which days. So over here we can see the highest number of people they are coming came was on Tuesdays. So Tuesdays and Wednesdays were the best part when people come to the website. See, in Search Console also we had seen that the highest number of people who were coming were on Wednesdays and Thursdays. Over here it is showing Tuesdays and Thursdays. So those were related to the calls and messages. Over here it is related to the traffic that people are coming. So this is correct. So this is matching. So now over here we get to know the sessions by the country. So how many people are coming from which part of the globe? So here we can see the highest number of people are coming from US over here, then say Canada, then over here say Brazil, then Russia, then India, then China. So many places people are coming, and over here we can see from South Africa one person came, then from Nigeria one person came, then from Australia we can see three people came, then different places, say Bangladesh, Indonesia, Vietnam, many people came from different places. And over here we get to know that the people came to our website were from desktop how many and mobile devices how many. So we can see that 82.6% of the people who came on our website came through desktops, and the rest of them, that is 17.4% of the people, came on mobile device. So this is what we get to know over here. Then these are the URLs. So which are the pages that people visited the most? So this is the URL. So this is the blog. So blog people visited 148 page views were there. The home page was visited 42 times. Then this particular blog was visited 6 times. This page was visited 3 times. So like this we get all the information of different pages on our website. So over here we will go into detail. So this is just an information about each and everything in short, whatever is performing, whatever is not performing, that we can see over here. But for each and everything individually we have the menus on the left hand side which we can see over here. So our report is divided into 5 different categories, that is real-time reports, audience report, acquisition reports, behavior reports and conversion reports. Now the reports which we are seeing over here, say all these 5 reports, say all these reports are not useful for everybody. Now say some of the reports related to behavior and conversions, these reports are used only by corporates and not by everyone else. So for this reason, any which ways we are going to study everything, we are going to see what everything is. So this is the bird's eye view of the dashboard, the basic information that we get about our website on daily basis whenever we check. So let's start with the first report, that is real-time reports. So this is the real-time reports where I can click on overview. So now under overview we get to know that how many people are there on our website right now. So this is the information that we see. So now right now you can see that there are no people on the website right now. So what I'll do is I'll just try to open the website in my website or in my mobile device. So just let me open it. Okay, so now I have opened the website on mobile device. It's opening, and yes, it is. It will take some time to load over here, because whatever is being loaded over here, this will be loaded in real time. That we can see over here. Now you can see right now one person. So one person you can see over here because I have logged in from mobile device. See over here, you can see mobile. You can see. So now I will open the website from my desktop. So I'll open this website over here. So okay. Oops. Okay, fine. I'll click over here, website. So this website I have opened it from here. So now let me check the analytics. So now you can see 2 users are there right now. So one on desktop and one on mobile device. So 50% from desktop, 50% from mobile. So that we get to know. Now over here we get to see that on which pages the people are on the top active pages. So this page, both of them are on the home page. So over here I'll click on blogs. And just let me see what is the change that I can see over here. So it should change because it is automatic. And over here we can see this is the real-time report which is going on. Now over here you can see the active pages blog slash blog. So on the home page over here we have clicked on blog. So one person is on the blog page and over here one person is on the home page. So from the mobile we are on the home page, and over here on the desktop we have clicked on blogs. So we get to know that over here we are on the blogs. So this is from the blog. So that information we can get. So this is real-time reports. You get to know that how many people are there online, then on which pages they are there, what they are doing. That all information you can get to know, that if they are going to, if they have on the product page, whether they have added the product to cart or not. These all information is very useful for the people who are having e-commerce websites, say like Amazon, Flipkart, these kind of website. For them it is very useful, because what happens is that they'll get to know that how many people are there on which product, and then they'll get to know that these products are very popular and other products which are not that popular, they can remove those products and add some more products or some other replace the products. So that all things information we can see. So this is real-time report. Now I just want to know some more information about it over here, say from which place they are, this is the location from where they are. So on the map it is showing over here India and it is showing Mumbai, but just let me click on the location and see the exact location of the person who are logged in. So over here we can see the people are logged in from India. So two active users are there, they are from India. So 100% of traffic is from India. So now I'll click on India and see what information do I get. So you can see one person from Mumbai, one person from Navi Mumbai. So like this we can see two people are logged in. So if there are people from multiple cities, then we get that information also over here. So that is what we can see. So this we can see over here, that is in location. Then I want to know what is the traffic source. So traffic source over here you can see it's organic. So this is organic, that is from Google. See, because how did I come to the website, on my website, how did I come to my website? See, I went to my listings and then I clicked on this website link. So this is organic because I came from Google. So if anybody is coming from a search engine, then that is Google. And over here on say mobile device, I had directly typed the URL in the browser. So that is a direct traffic. So now if I go to Facebook or say YouTube, then if I open the website from those places, then definitely the things would change over there. It will say social, so that we get to know that okay, fine, this many number of people have come from Facebook, or this many people have come from YouTube, this many people have come from any other social bookmarking website. See, we are doing all off page SEO, right? We are posting our website content on all different websites, and in search engine optimization we had learned that we have to do off page SEO so that more and more people will come to know. But now over here I will be getting information that which pages are performing, which pages are not performing. So I'll get to know that how many people are coming from which all places. But this is real-time report, so that is not a problem. But in audience report we will get that information. So I'll just click on about, and or else I'll go to post, and then I would click on any of the post which I have posted. Okay, so this is the blog. So I'll click from here and I'll come to my website on this particular blog. So now let me check what I can see over here. See, now you can see it has changed to social, and then it has shown over here Facebook. So now we get to know that okay, this person has come from Facebook and it is a social media. So the person who are coming directly, it will be showing as none. If it is coming from Google, then it will show as organic. If people are coming from social media website, then it will show as social. And the source also, they will say from direct traffic, they will say that they are direct. If they are coming from Google, then it will tell us that it is Google. If people are coming from Facebook, they'll tell us that it is sources Facebook, Google, YouTube, whatever source they are coming from. So this is how we get to know that how many people are coming from which places. So that is the traffic source. So then we get to see the content. So content we got to know that okay, fine, this person is from this particular place. Okay, this is at this coming from this particular page, and they are on this blog. So now just let me click on any of the tags, say Instagram. I'll click on Instagram tag, and then let me see that what information does it provide. So I get to know that okay, fine, this many people are there on this particular. See over here, you can see it has changed. So now we are on the tag page, and that is the tag that we have clicked on is Instagram, and this is the website URL on which we have performed this action. So it's basically helpopedia.com/tag/Instagram. It's like this. And then what is the page title? So that is Instagram Archives, and it's Helpopedia. So here also we can see the same thing, Instagram Archives, Helpopedia EduTech. So it will show us the exact page title that we can see over here. Whatever is the page name over here, that exactly it will show us. So this is the content. So from content we get to know that how many people are there on which pages of our website. So then that is useful to us. So from this also we can get to know that okay, fine, so many people are there on this page, so many people are there on this page, so many people are there on that page. So now every day we keep on monitoring, and then one fine day we get to know that, analyze that, okay, fine, that people were there on all these pages, and these two few pages did not have much traffic. So we need to change those pages or replace those pages or maybe modify those pages to get some more traffic. So for that reason, content is important. We need to keep checking the content report for that. Then over here, events. So events is something like say on the website, say people might have see newsletter subscription, but right now I don't have newsletter subscription added over here, or say we do not have any registration, or maybe right now we do not have a contact page where people can fill up a form and contact us. So if anything is there on the website, okay, I think the page has closed. I'll just check now. Oh, here, yeah. So if people are taking any action on our website, then that will come under events. So it could be like people are adding products to the cart, or people are purchasing something, or people are subscribing to our newsletters. That all information will come under events. So events is anything that is people are taking action on our website. So it can be anything like registering on the website. So if I have register an account, so people can register an account, so that is an event. So people can contact people can fill up the contact form, so that is an event. Then people can subscribe to my newsletter, so that is an event. People can purchase the products from my website, so that is an event. So any action that people are performing, that will come under events, right? So now the next thing is conversions. So conversion is basically the number of people who are coming on the website and whatever actions they have taken. See over here, say these are the things which I have added. The goals is I can add a goal that how many social sharing options I need. That see, okay, right now I don't think I have social sharing on my website, so I need to insert that plugin. So in my previous website I had all those options, so I need to add it again. So for that reason, at that point of time I had added the social sharing, so share on Facebook, share on Twitter, so that people can share my page. So that all information I can add, and then I can monitor all those things that okay, fine, so many people have shared on Facebook, so many people have shared on this particular place. It's basically building backlinks, so people will definitely share on their Facebook. So for that reason we are adding those social sharing buttons on our website, so our work becomes easy. Because what happens is that okay, say this is the page, this is the blog on which we are right now. Now, see, if people like this blog, what will they do? They'll click on that Facebook button and they'll share it on their Facebook page or on their profile, and they'll share it with their friends. But what information will go over there? Over there, the title will go with some information, and this particular URL will go. Now, if any of our website's URL is going out anywhere on social media, it means that we are doing off-page SEO. So people are helping us to do off-page SEO unknowingly. I mean, they are not knowing that they are doing off-page SEO for us. But it's basically link building. So our links are being built on various websites. So more number of accounts on Facebook, say more number of people of sharing on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, anywhere, on YouTube, wherever they want, or maybe they are sending this particular topic in their email. So that everything is counted as sharing. And it comes under off-page SEO, wherein say our links are being built. So that is sharing on, so that all things will come under conversion. So I will get to know that, okay, how many people have shared on my website. So I'll get to know that, okay, fine, so many people have shared, so many people are active on the users. Then the next thing is newsletter sign up. So from here I will get to know that, okay, fine, how many people have signed up on my newsletters. Then affiliate registration. So if I am having affiliate program like Amazon, so then people can sign up as an affiliate for my website and they can promote my courses and they can earn some commission, affiliate earnings for themselves. So that is affiliate registration, so people can do. And then 21 days unlocking series. So this is these are the two pages that I had added new 3 months back. And then I just wanted to study traffic on these two pages, so that was my goal. So these were the goals that I have set, and I just want over here in conversions, I will just get to know that for which goal, how much conversions have taken place. So that all information I get to know over here. So active users with goals. So right now I can see only one person is there, so that information we can see over here. So this was all real time reports, but this is real time reports is temporary, because once the person goes, then that report is gone, because we just get to know only real time reports. So for that reason, the next report is audience report, which is registered over here as a data. Now I click on audience report and I click on overview. So over here in this report, we will study everything about the users and their activities and their behavior over here. So behavior in the sense that how many pages they are browsing, how many users are coming, how many new users are coming, how many new sessions are there. So those all information we get to know. Then we get to know the bounce rate. So don't worry, I'll let you know what all these things are. Say the first thing that we can see in this report is users. So users is basically 144 users have come on our website, and this information is of past 1 week. So I will just increase the date over here so that you will get some more data and you will have some more clear information about this. So I'll do it from January 2019 to August 3rd, so that's fine. So I'll click on apply. Now you can see the change and you will see more information. So here now you can see 5,700 users, new users 5,750. Now say I have implemented this code on my website, or I have added this tracking ID which is registered on my website. Say it is integrated with my website over here. Under CO here it is says that it is connected, so it is fetching data from my website to Google Analytics. But by integrating that code on my website, how will Google get to know that so many users have come up and so many new users? Okay, users they can find that, okay fine, so many, because that many browsers are opening, so Google can track. But my question is, how will Google know that out of so many users, these are the new users? So new users is basically the people who are coming on the website for the first time. So if you deduct 5,750 from 5,752, then the remaining amount will be only 2. So it means that these two people have already visited this website previously. It means that they are old users. It means that they are returning users. They are not new users. So they are seeing this website for second time or third time or maybe multiple times. So now, just by implementing that code on my website, how will Google get to know that this person has come up on our website for the first time? Right? See, by touching the keyboard and opening the website in my browser and touching the mouse, Google will not get to know that, okay, fine, this person is seen this person for the first time, and he has visited this website, he is coming on the website for the first time. Or just by touching the keyboard, that person will not get to know that, okay, fine, he is a returning user, or he has come to this website for the first time. So how does all these things Google will get to know? See, you must be knowing something about cookies on your website, right? See, whenever a person will open any website over here, say suppose a person is opening this website, so what does this website do, my website or any website? They will leave some cookies in the system. So now this Google will fetch all the information from your system that whether this person has opened this website or not. So from all your browsing history, that cookie will get to know that, okay, fine, this person has visited this website on this particular date at this particular time. So then Google will say that, yes, this person is a returning user and this person is coming for the first time. So if the Google code will not find any information related to the cookies which is of this website, then they'll say that, okay, fine, this person is new, he has come to this website for the first time. So this all information is being calculated with the help of cookies which is placed by all the websites in your system. So that information we get, so we have got 5700 users and approximately 5750 new users. And sessions is, I've already told you, the once we open a website and we close that website, so that is one session. So opening and closing of a website is called one session. So we have 6795 sessions. Then you might say that we have only 5752 users, and how can sessions be 6795? Valid point. But let me tell you that say if I am browsing a website, I am browsing my website over here, and say by mistake I wanted to close this website and I close this website. So what happens that I was reading this blog and by mistake I close this. So again I will open this website and I will come to this page. So it means that my session were two sessions on this website. It will not be counted as one. So for that reason, over here you can see that number of sessions per user is 1.18. So there could be many people who might have opened the website and by mistake might have closed the website and again came to the website. So for that reason, it would say that it is 1.18. So if you calculate the percentage of number of sessions divided by this users into 100, then you will get this information, that is 1.18. so that is what we can see. This is the sessions per user, and then we can see page views. So this page views is 18,571. So it means that these all users have browsed 2.73 pages in per session on this website. So if you multiply 5752 users into 2.73 pages, then it will come to 18,571 approximately. So this is what the page uses. So out of all these users, this is what information we get, is 18,571. So ideally that is correct. So just let us be sure that, okay, fine, what I'm saying is correct or not. So 5752, it's into 2.73, okay, so it's 15,702. So now there is some difference over here. And yes, it is per session. So okay, so over here it is 1.18 session, and over here it's 2.73 pages per session. So here we are not counting multiple sessions, so over here we are counting only one session, and over here it is 1.18. for that reason over here the page views are higher, because this is for only one session and over here we have 1.18. So if I multiply, I think if I multiply this by 1.18, let me see, you can see this 18,529.49. So it's approximately matching this amount, the page views. So this is what it comes up to, sessions per user. So this is what it is. But over here we have calculated for all the users, but it might be that some of the users might have opened the pages multiple times, but some of them might have not even opened it for a single time, so only single time. So that is what we can see. So now this is that particular information of the people who are, how many people are coming in our website from this particular date range. In this date range, how many people have come to our website? Usually we study for past 30 days, so usually I can write that, okay, how many last 30 days. So that is what is the best information that we can get, that in past 1 month how many people have come to our website. So this is for 1 month, so that is what it is. And then we have average session duration. So now what is this average session duration? This average session duration is basically the amount of time they have spent on the website. So here we can see it's 0.0.52, so it's basically 52 seconds. People have spent only 52 seconds on the website. So this is average. It's not that everybody spent only 52 seconds. Some of them might have spent 1 minute, some of them might have spent even 5 minutes, but some of them might have even spent only 2 seconds, 3 seconds or 4 seconds. Some of them might have spent 10 minutes also. So for that reason, if you calculate everything, it is coming to an average of 52 seconds per user, which is very bad. So it means that we need to work on the website. But I have changed my website quite a many times and still the development is going on, so the results are not that good. So we can keep on checking this. Then the next thing we have is bounce rate. So bounce rate right now it's 85.15 in from past 1 month, because in past 1 month I have changed my lot of pages and website development is going on, so themes have been changed and everything. So what people are finding, so in past 1 month previously there were no pages, no individual course pages and everything. So for that reason people might just come on the website and they'll go. So what is bounce? So bounce is basically when people will come to any website and without clicking on any of the link on the website, and they will close this. So once I close this, then it is a bounce rate for Google. So this is called as bounce rate. So people are bouncing back, so people are coming on the website and going without taking any action on the website. So that is bounce rate. So if the bounce rate is high, then Google will not like this. So Google will say that you need to have maintain your bounce rate less than say 20% or 15% or maybe 25%. But lesser the bounce rate, Google will like your site more. So if the bounce rate is more, then Google will think that there is some problem on your website and people are not clicking on any other pages, they are just coming and going. So for that reason we have to maintain the bounce rate below as least as possible, but say ideally 20 to 25% is okay. That is not a problem. So that is bounce rate. Then over here demographics. So under demographics we get to know that people from which languages came to our website. See over here we can see various languages, that is US, the English US, English UK, then this is VN, some country, God knows. Then this is EN, India. Then this is normal, just English. then RU is Russia, then BR some countries. So these all languages are there. And from which language how many people came? See, we got to know that we have got 174 users, right? So these 174 users were speaking which language? So these were the languages they were speaking, and these are the number of people who have come from individual languages. So that is the information we get. Once I click on view full report, I will get details of all the reports, but on the left hand side menu we will be going detail into all those things, so we will be seeing more about the languages. Then we want to know about countries. So from which countries did people come to our website? So here you can see India 36, US 26, Vietnam 18, Indonesia 13, Brazil 16, Bangladesh 4. So like this, various list of countries people came, and from each country the number of users they have come to our website. Now drilling down more, we can see even from which cities did people come. See over here, not set. So not set is basically because people might be behind some firewall and Google code was not able to detect it. So in that case it might say not set. So then we have Mumbai. So from Mumbai we have 14, from this some Chinese city, I believe Ho Chi Minh City, 11 users. And then we have Jakarta, we have 6 people. So like this we have various people who have come to our website. So like this we get to know all the cities from where people have come. Okay, so the next thing is browsers. So now you get more information about the people who have come to your website. See, from which browser did people come to your website? See, Chrome, so many people, Firefox, so many people, Edge, so many people, Opera, Safari, Cocoa, then Internet Explorer, Android WebView, Yeah browser. So there are so many browsers are there from where people have come, and so many users have come through so many browsers. So this report also you get. Then you even get to know the operating systems over here. See, operating systems also you get. See, Windows, Android, Mac, iOS, Linux, Chrome. So all this information you get. So this is all the information you get, and the number of users coming from each and every operating system. And then we get to know service providers. So over here, service providers we are not seeing. So just let me increase the time so you can see some more service providers, because over here in this range there are no service providers being seen. So let me just increase from January 1st 2020 to August. So maybe we might get some service. See over here we can see say HubSpot, then Reliance Jio, then Devoice, then Amazon, Google, Bharti Airtel, then Lincode, then this space is statically assigned, then Facebook Ireland. So like this we get to know all the internet service providers from which they used on their devices or desktops or laptops, and they came to our website, because to come to our website they have to use some or the other internet service. So which were those internet service providers? These were the internet service providers which people came on our website. So that is service providers. Now this was for the system, desktops and laptops, and now we can see the mobile operating systems. So from which operating systems? Android we got 184 users, and iOS we got 24 users. So we also get to know that Android so many people are coming, iOS so many people are coming. Then we get to know service providers. So again, how many people who came from mobile devices, on their mobile devices which internet service they were using. So again you can see so many internet service providers: Reliance Jio, Bharti Airtel, Google, Vodafone India Limited, then Devoice, then India Cellular, Idea Cellular, then 236 Oka Industrial Estate. Okay, so this might be some ISP, and this is one more ISP which people might have connected to the public ISP at some civil hospital, something like that. and then one more ISP, Amazon technology. So like this, this many people have used these all internet service, and they came to our website, and then we can see the screen resolutions. Now you can see how deep the report is, how deep the report is going on. See, this is the screen resolution. The lowest screen was 360 into 640. So I might be, this is a olden days phones which were say used 20 years back. The screen resolutions are so small, like say 2 inch by 3 inch or 2 inch by 4 inch, something like that, that small screens. And the highest screen which we can see is 2000 by 2000. So now if I want to find out that which is the device through which this resolution is there, so I'll just click on 2000 by 2000, and then I'll get the information. You can see these all devices, Xiaomi, Apple, OnePlus and Samsung, these all devices were having this particular screen resolutions. So I mean, this is a very in-depth report which we are getting right now. Over here we can even find out what are the companies which are the mobile manufacturers from which the people came, so brand of mobile devices through which people came. So that information we got over here. So now if I want to know that which particular device that is, so say I'll go to say 2000 by 2000, then if I want to know that which what was the device which from Apple, so I click on Apple, then I will get to know that it was iPhone. So people had come from iPhone, so that information we got over here. So that is what it is. So now again coming back to screen resolution, so I'll click on OnePlus. So then I'll get to know some information about OnePlus, so which device it was. So it was, model number was 6010. So like this I get to know all the screen resolutions and all the models of each and every device. See, now you can see so many devices are there, so many models of the mobile device information is provided over here. So that is what we can see in this report. So that is all audience report over here we can see. Now we'll see active users. So how many people are active on our website in from say 1 day to 28 days, so 1 days to 1 month, how many people are usually active? So over here it says that if I calculate only for 1 day, then in 1 day approximately 6 people are coming. Now if I calculate for 7 days, then for 7 days it is approximately say 144 people. Then if I say 14 days, then it is 174 people, and if I say 28 days, then it is 174 people. So this is how I get to know that on an average how many people are coming from to our website in 1 day or say in 1 month. So that is the information we can see. So I mean, this all information is utilized by all high-end companies who want to analyze the data for every second, that how many people are coming on their website, how many people are purchasing on their website. So especially these kinds of reports are very useful for the websites who is having high amount of traffic, say like Amazon, Flipkart, and I mean even small e-commerce websites, or even small websites who are doing businesses online. So that all information we get over here in active users. Now this lifetime value and cohort analysis, this both the reports are in beta stage, so we don't have any information over here. So once that report will be launched properly, at that point of time we will get some more information. This is cohort analysis, so right now we don't have any information. Most of the things are 00 over here, we just see some percentage over here, and rest of the things is 00. So like this we will get to see the report. So basically this would be the acquisition date and the amount of percentage of the people we are acquiring on each day. So I can say that okay fine, on this particular day, say day 0, how many people came. So I calculate the number of visitors who are converting to customers in this week, then I'll get to know that, okay, fine, on Monday 100 people joined, on Tuesdays 125 people joined, then on Wednesday nobody joined, then on Thursday 500 people joined. So like this, on daily basis, how many people are coming to our website and how many people we are acquiring on our website. So probably this could be that report. So once the report will be switched from beta to production, at that point of time you will get the exact information of this report. Then the next report is audience report. So under audience report, over here we will see all the users who have come in this particular date range, that is in the year 2020. How many people have come? That is 790 users have come. New out of this, new users were 785, the sessions were this many, so this many browsers opened or this many tabs opened, and this was the bounce rate. So many people bounced the website, they just came on the website and went away, and they just some of them just browsed 1.92, so approximately 2 pages on the website, and they stayed for 1 minute and 47 seconds on the website. So that is what it is. And over here, this is all the information that if we are an e-commerce website and if we are selling something, then we will get information about how many transactions happened in this duration, what was the revenue collected, and what is the conversion rate in terms of percentage. So that all information we would get. But right now we do not have any products on the website, and I am not selling any products on my website right now, so I don't have this information. So this is what this report shows into audience. Now the next thing is user explorer. So user explorer, see, I was talking about the cookies and how will Google get to know that this person is a new user or this person is old user. So there is one more thing which is which has to be identified, that is called as client ID, that is also called as device ID. So device ID is basically a number which each and every device will have. Device in the sense laptop, desktop, then mobile phones, tablets, then smart televisions with which we can browse internet, then Xbox, then gaming consoles. These all devices will have a different unique device IDs. So it is as good as you can say the IMEI number that we have in our cell phone, but those IMEI numbers are not the device IDs. So device ID is on the PCB. So unless and until you do not change the motherboard of the phone or desktop or say laptop, that device ID will remain the same. So these are all the device IDs that I have registered. See over here, these all device IDs are registered of the people who came on the website. So now over here, if I just want to know that what did this person do, so I do not know who that person is, but over here I just get to know that what did he do. So this is all registered, say like client ID and BigQuery ID. So this is all Google will be storing all that information. Then when was the date last seen? So this person was seen last on this website on 17th February. When did he first come? So he first came on 2nd of February on this website. And how did he come? So he came through a direct campaign, and there was no source or medium. The channel was direct. And what are the things did he do on the website? So here we can see 201 instances of that person. So I'll just see all the instances over here, so I can just scroll down. So there were total 41 sessions from this person. So this person could be a male, this person could be a female, he could be in any part of the world. We do not know from where he is, but we can just find out what did this person do on our website. So here if I click on this, I'll get to know that this person first came on 2nd February at 11:19 a.m. in the morning, and he stayed on the website for 20 minutes 44 seconds. He came through a desktop device which was a Windows platform, and the data source was web. So he came through web. And then how did he come? He came directly because he knew the URL of the website, so for that reason he came directly. Then what did that person do? See, over here he had two events. So two events could be like he might have signed up for a newsletter, or he might have shared something on the website. So that could also be possible. And he has viewed three pages. So which were those three pages? So here we can see the pages. See, this is the event that was performed, that is on Google Optimize. Then this was the page that he viewed, this was the second page that he viewed, and this was the second event, and this is the third page that he viewed, and this is again completed goal share social. So he shared the content on social media. So I mean, he just shared from the icon which I had on my website, share it. So that share this, basically. So that is a plugin which I can install in my WordPress, so with which I can have Facebook, Twitter and all those information on my website, and people can click on Facebook icon and share this page on their Facebook account. So that is what. So here that this person has shared. Then next he came again after say approximately 30 minutes over here, again at 11:42 a.m. and then again that person came through a referral link, because say over here it was a referral link, and then again he came on a desktop PC, again it was Windows desktop, so probably the same PC, and the data source was again web, and then he had one goal completed, that is for sharing, and then he had viewed four pages. So which were those four pages? So here we can see the list of pages. So this was the first page, second page, third page and fourth page. So these were the pages that this person saw on the website. So this is what we get to know. So now we can see in-depth information about all the users who have visited the website from 2006 on my website. So I mean, you can just imagine what kind of data Google is giving to us. So how will this data be useful for me just by finding out all this information? Now if you study, if you have time, so basically you yourself might or might not study. If you are an individual, then we would definitely study, but for a company there is a whole department sitting who will be analyzing the behavior of the people who are coming on the website. So they might say that okay, fine, so many people are coming on so many pages, the best platform they are coming is through Windows desktop, and the best time they are coming is in the night time, or maybe early morning they might be coming, and they are visiting, on an average they are visiting this many pages, and they can calculate that okay, fine, in this much time if they are visiting this many pages, then average duration of the staying of that person on one page is this much. So that can be calculated, so that's quite easy. So they'll understand the human behavior, that what is that person looking for, how many pages did he browse, how many times did that person come again to the website, what was the frequency of coming back on the website, say maybe 1 hour, 30 minutes or 2 hours or something like that, or maybe he is coming after 2 days, 3 days, 5 days. So basically we can study each and every information about that person. So like this, if we, this is what we are talking about, just one person. But over here if I increase the date range, then you can see thousands and thousands of client IDs. So I mean, you need people to analyze this data. So over here right now we have 794 client IDs who have come up in just 2020, that is from 1st January to August 3rd, which was yesterday. So this all information we get to know, said 794 client IDs, and we need to study each and everyone. So not each and everyone, but say randomly we can just test a few client IDs, that what is the average behavior of the person coming on which pages they are browsing, one person how many pages did he browse, and did he particularly browse any particular page on the website. So that all information we can gather, and which will help us to enhance our website. So maybe we can use that data and check our website, that what are these pages and how these pages are helping to people, or which pages are not helping to people, where people are not staying on the pages. So that all information we can get to see in User Explorer. Then second information we have is second report is demographics. So under demographics we get to know more interesting things about the people who are coming. See over here we get to know the age of the person. See over here we find that people coming on the website are 18 to 24. 33% of the users coming on the website are 18 to 24. Then 34% of the users coming on the websites are 25 to 34. Then 23.81% coming on the website are 35 to 44 age range, and 7.94% of the people are the age range of 45 to 54 years. Now you just imagine, how will Google get to know, say if I am browsing your website, how will Google get to know that I am of this age? I mean, this is really interesting, right? Because tell me.
Maybe from Gmail, like when we made the Gmail account, they asked by that.
See, we were talking about the client ID in the previous over here under User Explorer. See, now that client ID, Google will check that, okay, this client ID, this device ID, then this device ID, does this device ID have any Gmail account or any Google properties attached to this device ID? Then it will check all the properties. It might be anything. It might be Google My Business account or maybe Gmail account or any other account that this person might have. So for that reason, from there Google will get all the information, whatever data that person has filled up. So maybe he might have a Gmail account. So in Gmail we have provided our first name, last name, date of birth, phone number, age, and everything we have provided. So from that information Google will get all this information. I think it has changed a bit. Okay, fine. So yeah, so from there Google will get all this information about what is the information about these people, what is the age of these people. So like this they can calculate. See they can even find out whether that person is a male or female. So definitely from the data that we have filled up on Google, from there they'll get to know whether they are male or female. So that information can also be get. Now here I am seeing that 33% of the users were 18 to 24 years of age. Okay, that is fine, 33.33, but I want to know that how much is that 33.33 in numbers. So for that reason I can just click on age and I will get that information, that how many people from which age range. See, 25 to 34, 44 users, 18 to 24 years of age, and 42 users. So 30 users from the age range of 35 to 44 and 10 users of 45 to 54 users. So that is the information that we get. The same information we can get it for the gender also, that how many are male, how many are female. So from male, 102 male came on the website and 41 female came on the website. So that is what we can see over here. So that all information we get to see over here. Then we get to see interest. See, now how will Google get to know the interest? Okay, in Gmail I have added all my personal details, but I did not add any of my interest, that okay, I belong to technology or I belong to media or I belong to lifestyle or I belong to shoppers or I belong to food and dining, something like that, or I am into business services or I am into softwares, whatever it is. I mean, Gmail does not ask all that personal information while filling up the form for Gmail. It will just ask the basic information which I am providing. So how do we find this information? How does Google find out this information? So again, that device ID which we had seen in User Explorer, again that will come into picture. That device ID, the cookies which our website is leaving. So whenever that person opens our website, then the cookies from that website will again go into that system and search for all the cookies present in the system. Then it will check for all the website history of the website that you have visited, that is your browsing history. It will check each and every information about you. So then it will decide that okay, fine, there is this Gmail account associated with this device ID, and this person has visited so many websites from say maybe in past 10 years or 20 years or 15 years, whatever till date that person has browsed so many websites. So then Google will categorize those websites into different categories, and from those categories we get to know that okay, fine, this person belongs to this category over here. Say this person belongs to shoppers, or this person belongs to media, this person belongs to technology, this person belongs to media, something like that. So it will automatically divide. So over here we have affinity categories, in market segments, and some other categories. So under affinity categories we have many categories, under in market segments we have various categories, and other categories we have quite a few other categories also that we can see over here. So again, these all are in percentage. So if I want to see in numbers, so I can click on affinity categories and I get the numbers of the people who are coming on the website. So shoppers and value shoppers, 128 people. Media and entertainment music lovers, 115 people. Lifestyles and hobbies, shutterbugs, so 114 people. Technologies, 103 people. Media and entertainment, 92 people. So we can see that from each and every category we can see the users. So now how does this data help us that if some people are coming from this categories on my website, say 128 is the highest number, that is shoppers and value shoppers. So shoppers and value shoppers are the people who like to shop, and they frequently shop online or anywhere. So now if I have something to sell on my website which they might be interested in, then definitely they would purchase. And if I am not selling anything on my website, then these shoppers, value shoppers who are coming on my website will go as a waste, because I do not have anything to sell and they will not buy anything from my website. So I am losing a lot of opportunities from the people who are coming on my website. So for that reason I can use all this information and put it up in my website that okay, fine, so I'll decide okay, shoppers, value shoppers, so I can add some products. Media and entertainment, so I can add some products related to this category. Then lifestyle, hobbies and shutterbugs, so I can add some categories, something like this on my website, something related to technology, something related to media, something related to entertainment, something like that, everything related. So initially I don't say that we start all the categories and we add everything on our website. Not like that. Sometimes it might not be possible to add everything. So for that reason what we could do is we will select only top 5 categories which are having high number of users, and select those products. And even out of those top 5 categories, if I can provide products only for one or two categories, it's fine. So I would select those categories and add products on my website, or maybe even services, not necessarily products only. So it could be anything which they would like to buy, so I can add. And if something is of their interest, then definitely they would keep coming back on our website. That is the most important thing. See, and why Google is giving us this report, why are we using Google Analytics in first place? The first place we are using Google Analytics so that we are getting all this information. Now just imagine that Google Analytics is giving us all these reports, and if we are not using this report, Google Analytics, then just think, we are missing on a lot of information, right? So we should use all this information to enhance the profitability of our website. by implementing and knowing that okay, so many people are coming on our website now, they are these type of people, they are of this age, say they are more youngsters, they, or maybe more mid-age people or older people, then what all things I have for youngsters or mid-age people or older people? Do I have anything for them, or they are just coming and going empty hand? No, it should not be like that. We should have something for them. So for that reason, these all reports are provided. From each and every category, each and every menu that we are studying on the left hand side, it has some purpose for it. Now you just imagine each and everything from the left hand side menu and think that how can I enhance, I can take this report and enhance my website taking this report into consideration. Say like the previous report which we had taken, like demographics, I get to know that people of 25 to 34 is the highest, that is 44. So do I have anything for this age group? Do I have any product or any service or anything that will interest these kind of age group? If I don't have, then I need to do something about it. Then I would get business from this website. Otherwise, just having a website will not help. So that is information which we can use. So over here the same thing in market segments, and over here also we can see various categories having the number of users and the new users and sessions and all those information that we can take. And the same way we have information about other categories, so that also we can see. So if anything is matching related to our website, then we can definitely try to add them and make sure that people do not go empty hand from our website. So that is interest. Then this is geo. So geo is basically geography, that what language did people, what type of languages do people speak. So in dashboard we had seen the languages, different languages that people were speaking. So here we can see these languages over here. So there are approximately 43 languages, different languages through which people are coming. So I'll select 50 and we can see all of them over here. So many languages of people are speaking, and these people from all these languages are coming to the website. So that this is language report. And then we have location report. So location report, again the cities and countries where we can see all this information, how many people from which country people have come, and out of this country how many were total users, how many were new users, what was the percentage of sessions that they opened, and what was the bounce rate. So again we get to know that okay, fine, that so many people are coming from this particular state, this many countries people are coming. Then over here we can see that the bounce rate is 100%. So then we need to study that why Vietnam and Indonesia are having the highest bounce rate. Probably it could be their internet connection is quite poor and the site did not load properly, or maybe there is some problem with our website and our website is opening very slow in slow internet connection. Maybe even if they are using 2G or 3G and if the website is not opening, then there is a problem with our website. So definitely there we would get more bounce rate. So we should make sure that the website is also opening fast. So this is what we had studied in Page Speed Insights when we were studying about the speed of a mobile and speed of desktop, where the speed of mobile was very less, that was 21, and on desktop it was say ranging around 51 to 57, something around that figure. So this is what we need to know. See, it is not that we just take data from here and analyze over here itself. We take data from different modules that we have learned. See, now I just connected Google Search Console and Google Analytics. See, from Google Search Console we just got to know about the information about our website speed. So, and over here I can see that in Vietnam, Indonesia and UAE, that is United Arab Emirates, we can see 100% bounce rate is there. So why there is so much of bounce rate from these countries? say from Germany also we can see 90% is bounce rate. So for this reason we should see that what are the problems related to our website. So again we need to go back to Search Console and see if Google has detected any issues or not. So I mean, in one day you will not get all that information. So you, if you are studying this Google Analytics every month for your website, and one fine day you get to know that your bounce rate is increasing, then again you will go back to Search Console and again you will check whether every problem, if there is any problem or not. But any which ways, you will be going to Google Search Console every 2 days and check whether there is any problem or not. So I don't say that you just go on the Google Search Console only when you have problems. No, it's not like that. You will keep checking each and every module every 2 days. Say Google My Business is the module where you always have to be on Google My Business, because people might connect you on your device without say having WhatsApp or SMS. They might message you or they might even call you. So for that reason you have to have installed an app called as Google My Business from Android Play Store or say App Store, iOS App Store. So I mean, all the modules have equal and importance which we need to know, and definitely data from one module can be taken and analyzed with the second module. Say like we took data from Search Console and over here we are comparing that data with Google Analytics and finding the reason of the problems. So if you know each and everything in detail, then definitely you will find a way. See, now I just recollected that okay, Vietnam and Indonesia is having 100% bounce rate. So the problem could be that their internet is very slow because people do not like to wait for a website to open if it is taking ages. So that could be one of the case. The second reason could be that their internet is fast, but my website is slow. My website server is not opening properly. My website is running very slow. The images are quite high, so for that reason the website is not loading. So there could be many reasons. So for that reason I connected this 100% problem with the Search Console, that what could be the problem on my website and how can I find out. So if there is any problem, then Google will definitely send us a message that okay, you have a problem, one new problem has been detected on this website at this particular time, and this is the problem, you need to fix this. So see, I can analyze the second issue which is related to my website, but if his internet is slow, I cannot do anything. I cannot test anything. The only thing is that I can just sit and wait for the next month and see whether again the traffic is coming from Vietnam or not, or whether the bounce rate has decreased or not. So that is the only thing which I can do, but whatever is in my hands I will definitely do it. So second thing was in my hand, that is checking my website, considering all the problems related and detected in Search Console. So this is all the report related to this location. We get to know the different locations. Yeah.
Suppose we don't have any problem in our website
Yeah.
and still the bounce rate
See,
is
then in that
good,
case, there could be, see, many reasons. See, over here, if you are getting more bounce rate, then it could be that person came to our website, but it was not related to him. See, if I am not related to digital marketing, or if I am not related to chemical engineering. See, I am into digital marketing, but by mistake I open a website which is related to chemical engineering. Then what will I do? I don't need to browse that website, that what they are offering, what they are doing. That is none of my business. That is not my category of business. So I'll definitely just click that website without going to any other pages. So that could have even happened. That person might have opened this website and he might have found that this website might not have any information related to him, or this website is not related to his category. So I mean, there could be many reasons. See, we should not blame all the time to us, but yes, we should take a lot of precautions from our side. See, at least there should not be any mistake from our side. So that all precautions we need to take, but you should not blame yourself that okay, fine, so there is so much of bounce rate on from so many countries and people might have not been able to see my website. Don't worry, just wait for another month, and if still this thing continues, then probably you can see that if from the other reports also which we are seeing, which we are going to see from there also, we will get some more information related to these countries, that from where are these people coming. Say the people who came to our website from Vietnam or from Indonesia, from where did they come? What was the landing page? What was the source from where they came? Then we will get to more deeper insights. I will get to know. So still we have more information. Just from this report, I can just find out that okay, fine. Oh, here we are getting more bounce rate. But at this point, I do not need to take any tension, or do not need to worry a little also. I just need to know that okay, from these countries there is 100% bounce rate. So okay, that's fine. So I'll just key a note it. I'll take a note down. So then I will see other reports and I'll find out that okay, from where, what is happening and everything. So then we'll get to know some more information about this. So that definitely we'll be seeing in the coming reports also. You will see everything. See, then we have new versus returning. See, we were talking about that, how will Google get to know that about this is new users and old users. So that we found out, that was from the device ID. Now over here it is giving us that how many new visitors have come on the website and how many returning visitors are coming. So 97 people of the now 97 people who came on the website were not for the first time, they were for the second time, third time, or maybe multiple times. They were returning users. And new users are the people who might have found out about our website and they are coming to our website. So that's fine. But we should also make sure that the returning visitors should also be more. Because see, if I buy one thing from Amazon, if I like the service, I'll again go to Amazon, right? The same way, if a person is coming to my website, he is buying something he might not like and he might never come back again. So that could be the situation also. So I should make sure that there is everything for all the people who are coming on my website. Why people are not returning on my website after seeing my website once? They should come second time, they should come third time. See, only 97 people out of the total 794 people came back. So 700 people did not come, 788 people did not come on my website again. So I mean, I lost those people. What happened to those people? So for that reason, we should make sure that we have all the information, all the products or services related to all other people who are visiting our website, which we studied in demographics, the age of the people, the category of the people, the interest of their people. Those all things we studied over here. So we should take care of them. Then people will come over here. Then people will like to come again and again. So of course we need new people, but we cannot lose the old people. We want everybody to come on our website again and again. So that is our motto. So that is new versus returning. Then we have frequency and recency of the people who are coming on our website. So over here we can see the frequency. Say out of 2,068 page views, there were 1,077 sessions. So it means that in 1,077 browsers, 2,068 pages were browsed. So that is what it is showing over here, that the number of sessions and the number of page views, this many page views. Then over here, number of sessions. So instead of sessions, I can say browsers or new tabs. So it could be a new tab or a new browser altogether. So out of 789 browsers, 1,275 page views were seen. So similarly like this. But now you might say that this report is good because this is having some more data and the bar is also quite long. No, it's not like that. See, the more number of people who are coming and visiting this page, see, if you divide 1275 by 789, then it is not even 2 pages browsed by a person. It would be approximately 1.8 or 1.7% 1.7 pages a person is browsing. So for that reason, if we should always make sure that people are staying on the website for a longer period of time, and the page views also should be more. So that is what we need to see. See over here, we can see that, see, 9 to 14 sessions, so many people came, say 15 to 26 sessions, this many people came. So like this we get to know all the information. So this many page views were seen on the website. So that is frequency and recency. So how many pages people are seeing in the number of sessions or the browsers they are opening on their system. So that is the report. And then we have engagement report. So engagement report is, we get to know that how long does people stay on our website. So over here we can see 916 pages were seen by 831 sessions, and those people stayed on the website for only 0 to 10 seconds. So again we can see over here, in 10 seconds so many pages were browsed. So you can just imagine that this report is not good. So over here we can see, as you scroll down over here, if you go downwards, see the time limit is increasing. People are staying for more amount of time, say 3 minutes, 4 minutes, 5 minutes, 6 minutes, 10 minutes, something like that, and even more than say 1801 seconds. So that is 6 threes are 18, more than 3 hours. So 3 hours people are staying, and over here in 3 hours people have browsed 221 pages. So it means that people have read the full pages or full articles. Now just imagine the in 10 seconds, if you say that so many people opened so many pages, in 10 seconds will people be even able to read even one paragraph? I don't think so. So this is the more amount is not good, the less amount is good, because people are staying over here for more amount of time, and they are reading more number of pages. That is the most important. We want these kind of people who are staying on the website for a longer duration of time and who are reading more pages of our website. So that is engagement report, how well they are engaging with our website. So that is engagement report. The next report that we have is technology report, that is on browser and OS. We have already seen the people who are coming from browsers and different operating systems. So over here we get some more information that say from Chrome, how many users are coming, Android, how many users are coming. So these are all the browsers, and these are number of users coming from each and every browser, and how well they are performing. See over here we are seeing how well the browsers are performing. Then we can see how good the operating systems are performing. Over here we were seeing about the behavior, where we were seeing how the frequency is performing, how the engagement is performing. So I mean, from all these reports you have to learn that we have various things to learn, and how we can use this data to enhance our website. See over here, different users, different browsers, and the number of users, what is more popular for people they are using, and how they are coming on our website or how they are reaching on our website. That is more important for us. And see, go here, Chrome, Android, WebView, then Firefox, Safari, various browsers are there. So that is all browser and operating system reports. And the next report is network. So network is basically all the internet service providers that we have. So we get to see over here, HubSpot is there, then Reliance Jio is there, then D-Voice, Broadband, Amazon Technologies, Google, Bharti Airtel, then iNode. So various internet service providers are there in India, or say throughout the world, through which people are coming on our website. So maybe in US people are using something else, in India people are using something else. See over here we can see Google. So it is not necessary that if it is Google then people, this is used by the people from US. No, all our Mumbai railway stations are powered by Google Wi-Fi. So whatever Wi-Fi you are using on Mumbai railway stations, they are all powered by Google Wi-Fi. So we are using Google in India also. In India, see, it is not available for home users over here in Mumbai, but all the railway stations are definitely powered by Google. So it's from India also. See, Bharti Airtel Limited, this is again from India. Then iNode. So iNode, I haven't heard that if this is from India, this could be somewhere from abroad. Then this space is actually statically assigned. So this is the very weird name of the ISP that they have kept. And see over here, Facebook Ireland Limited. So this belongs to Ireland, not in India, because in India we do not have ISP of Facebook. So like that, we can see Amazon Technologies. We do not have ISP of Amazon Technologies in India. Dvoice belongs to Mumbai. Reliance Jio belongs to India, Mumbai, or say whole of India. So HubSpot belongs to US. So like this, we have various ISPs through which people are coming, and these are the number of people are using these internet and they are coming on our website. So that is all network report, and the next report is mobile report. So then coming to the mobile report, we have overview of the mobile devices. What type of devices do people come on our website? So if we talk that, we know that, okay, 794 is the fixed number of people who have come up on our website. So in previous reports we could see that out of 794 people, how many people came through Chrome browser, how many people came through Android, how many people came through Safari or other browsers. Now the same type of report, out of the same 794 people, how many people came on desktop, how many people came on our website through mobile, how many people came on the same website through tablet. So here we have all that information, that people coming on our website through desktop, mobile devices or tablets. We can see over here all that data is listed. So this is all the information related to mobile devices. And if I click on devices, you will be surprised to see all the devices through which people have come on our website. So I mean, there is no limit to the amount of people using the different devices. So over here we would see more number of devices through which people have come up on our website. So it's just updating. Okay, so yes, so you can just see each and every device. So all these devices through which people have come on our website. So model number of each and every device. So you get exact device model number, that okay, people came through Samsung mobile or Xiaomi Redmi 6A, then Vivo V11, OnePlus 6, then Xiaomi Redmi Note 4, then Google Compute Engine, then Google Nexus 5, so various devices, Oppo F9 Pro, then Apple iPad, Xiaomi Y2, Redmi Y2. So we get to know all the devices. Now you might say that, okay fine, previous reports we can use all that information, but how will this device report will help me? See, like it's before starting this in analytics session, I had told that we have 5 categories of the report, and it is not necessary that all reports may be useful to us, useful to each and everyone. So for some, device report might be important and not, demographic report might not be important. For us, demographic report is important and not the device. But if you tell me that how to use this device report, even if it is not useful for me, see, if I would have been a developer and I am developing an Android app, then I should know that so many people are coming on my website, and I should make sure that my products are compatible with all these devices. But that's still fine. See, now if I am seeing that so many people are coming through so many devices, now I get to know that, okay fine, these all devices are, some of the devices are very high-end devices, and I need to check that my website is compatible with all these devices, because people might browse my website on these devices. So definitely people have already browsed on these devices and they came on my website. So for that reason I got this report already. So I should make sure that my website is compatible with all these devices, so that I can gain more business. They'll find that okay, there is no glitches in accessing the website on these devices. So like that, I can use all these devices. So that would be helpful for me also. Now the next report is cross-device report, which is again in beta stage. So I don't think there is any information related to this report also. So yes, no data, no data. So once this report comes up, I mean maybe whenever it comes up, we can see that report, or even you can check it, and if you face any problem, you can always get back to me. Then we have custom reports. So custom reports and user-defined reports, both are one and the same. So basically, you can define all the reports. Now, till now, we have seen a lot of reports over here, right? So now these reports which are seeing, so now from this I want to compare maybe two three things. That okay, fine. The first thing I would like to know that how many people were from the age of 18 to 24. Then I would like to know that which browsers were they using, and then I would like to know from which countries they were coming. So what I can do is I can create a custom variable over here. I can create custom reports over here. I can see what I want to select. See, I will click on sessions, and over here you can see all the things that we have seen in our previous report. See, bounce report, pages per session, average session duration, then AdSense. So this is for the revenue generation on the website. Then this is e-commerce. So e-commerce information is there. Then that is average order value per value sessions and all these things. Then goal settings, so these are all the goals that I have set. See, 21 days unlocking series, then affiliate registrations. I can select any of these sessions, and I can again select one more session over here. I can compare the two sessions, and I can get report over here that okay, fine, I'll select say pages per session. And the second thing I want to select is maybe commonly used is say average session duration. So average session duration, so I can compare these two reports and I can get some information. But over here the report is not available for this combination of report. So this is an example of how I can create my own reports over here. And then what I can do is I can share this report. So I can basically automate this report. What I can do is say if I am checking this report every week, I do not need to come over here and again come over here to the custom variables and again select whatever I want, and then I'll again select the parameters, and then I'll click on save and check everything. No, I will just click on save. See, after selection of my parameters, I'll just click on save. I'll give it a name, and then I'll click on OK. And then I can get all the reports once I come back. I'll just show you where it is saved. And after saving, what I can do is I can download the reports. See, export. So I can export this report in PDF. I can export the report in Google Sheets, then Excel sheet or CSV sheets, in any type of report I can get. So if I click on PDF file, I'll just see how I'll just show you how does it look like. So it is exporting to PDF, and then it will ask me where do you want to save. So I'll save it on desktop. So fine, it is exporting, and yes, it is asking me. So I'll select on desktop, and then I'll click on save, and okay, it is already saved. So now I'll open that report. So now you can see the same report. It's with the same data, the same interface, everything is same. So every time if I want, I can get this report directly. And if I want to compare it, I can download the report, and I can check offline all those things. And now if this is a report which I'm checking frequently, then what do I do? I'll just click on share and share, and I'll put my email address over here, and I will write the topic name that okay, fine, this is Google Analytics report, and this is custom variable report related to so and so. So then I'll get to know that okay, fine, this is demographic report, or it is say interest report, or geographical report, or active users report, whatever report it is. And what format do I want to be attached in my email? So I'll say that I want PDF file, so that is fine. And what is the frequency? If I want this report only once, then I'll select once. If I want every week, then I might select daily. If I want daily reports, yes. And if I want weekly, then I'll select weekly reports. If monthly, then I can select monthly reports, or I can even get quarterly reports. So if I say that I want this report weekly, then what would I do? If I want this report weekly, then on which day I want? I want at the starting of the week, that is on Monday. So every Monday I will get an email directly from this particular dashboard. I'll just enter my name over here, my email address over here, and I'll just select I'm not a robot, and then I can just click on submit. So after clicking on submit information over here, send, so it will automatically be scheduled, and I will keep on getting this email report in my email every Monday. Now where does this report get saved? So over here in customization. So in customization, if I see all the saved reports, I can see all the saved reports. So here we can see all the various kinds of reports. So next time I want to come over here, so I don't waste time, so I'll just click on this. If I want to see any other information, so interest, affinity, category, so I'll select that option and I'll get this information. Then I'll just need to update the date range, that okay fine, it was for last week, now I want for this week, and then I will say save it, or I will export it, so I'll download that report. So like this I can save various kinds of reports, and so that it will save time, because if you go deep into each and every report, then you can see how deep it is. So from one to another, another to third one, and then you need to find where you are and where do you need to know, because it might not be immediately possible for you to remember all the menu options, that which option is at which place. So for that reason, you can, whatever report you want, you can just save those reports, and you can give them a name of that report, and then you directly go to customization and click on saved reports, and you can access that report over there from there. So I mean, over there also you can change the dates and you can get the latest report, so that is fine. So this is how you check your reports, and you can customize your reports. So yes, that was related to custom reports and user defined reports. And the second thing, now the next thing is benchmarking. So benchmarking is basically we get information about the verticals, so different vertical industries through which the traffic is coming. So here you can see various categories of the people, or various category of the industries. So over here I might select anything. So if I just want to know about say if people are coming from internet and telecom or something like that, say all internet and telecom, so then it will get updated, and over here I do not see anything. So for that reason nothing is coming up over here. So that is, I mean, I just want to see the different people coming from different verticals, and what is performing, what is not performing, that all information I can see over here. Okay, then I want to select any particular country, I can select all countries, so that information I can get. And what is the size, so size I can select whatever is the size, so that all information I would get over here. So now you can see, so all the information related. So previously I was not getting all that information because the size was not selected. So this information is shown from all the industry verticals, then from all countries, and the size is quite big, so that's not a problem. So now over here in benchmarking I will get all the channels. So channels means the direct channels. So direct channels is the people who know my website URL and who directly type on the website on the browser and come to my website, so that is direct. So under direct, say from July 28 to 20, so this is for past 1 week's report. So in past 1 week, say there were very less sessions, so 99% was less. New sessions were quite more, 90.38% was quite more. So okay, that is good. We can see something good about the website, that new people have come up, but the sessions were quite less, so this is disappointing. The new users were also say minus 99.97, and then I can see pages per session have decreased to 51.75%. then I can see average session duration also have been reduced to 96%. So people are not staying on my website for longer period of time. So that is average session duration, and the bounce rate is 150.6%. So I mean that is quite high. So I need to check on that also. So the direct business is not working. So the people who know my business, so maybe it's like they are taking my business for granted, and maybe they are not serious about it. Now the second thing is the people who are searching on Google and coming to the website. So we get to know that what is performing and what is not performing. So whatever you can see in red arrow, which is going down, so that is minus, so that is not good. And whatever we are seeing in green, which is at the top arrow, so that is going on the top, which is good. So here everything is fine. So now only in the bounce rate, if the bounce rate goes down, then that is good. Except see over here, everything, all the red arrows are going down, that is bad. But if green arrow is going down, then it is good. So whatever is green, that or everything is good, but the rest of the channels are not performing. Only some of the channels are performing at some places. So I need to improve on the website and make sure that okay, fine, this channel is working, this channel is working. See referral. So this is referral, so referral is not working. So right now, say I need to do referral off-page SEO. So off-page SEO I need to do. Say social is also not that good working. So I need to post some new post. I need to engage more number of people on my website and social media accounts. So all that things I need to do on social media. Others, so I mean that is out of question. So because we do not know what others is, so that is something which might be behind firewall or say provided by just Google. So only Google might know what this is. Then others is display. We have so display advertising, email advertising, and other advertising. So this is paid. So I mean we should not be worried about the display advertising or other advertising or paid search, because if we are not doing any paid marketing, then we should not be worried about it, because we are not spending. We are just taking efforts and time to make our website grow. So this is what we can see under channels, what channels are performing, what channels are not performing. So that is what we can see in benchmarking. Then the next thing is location. So again the same information, instead of channels over here we have locations. So from which country, what is working and what is not working, what is going down, then the new sessions are increasing from these all channels, the new users are going down, then pages per sessions are going down from all these countries, then average session duration is also going down from all these countries, and the bounce rate is also increasing quite high from these countries. So I need to work a lot on my website for these countries, or maybe overall on my website, and then maybe people might like to see the website. So that is related to the locations. Then we have the same information related to the devices, through which devices, what is working, what is not working. So that is from mobile device, tablets and desktops. So what is working? So people who are browsing through desktops, over there also it's not working. People working coming on mobile, even that is not working. And people coming on tablet, any which ways, nowadays people are not using that much tablets, and the traffic is quite low from tablets. So that is okay. But desktops and mobile should be more, because those are say mobiles and tablet should be more, because those are portable devices. But mostly people use mobile phones, because nowadays the mobile itself are quite big and almost equivalent to a tablet. So we should be worried about the mobile devices. So only one thing is good over here, that is the new sessions, the new people who are coming to the website through mobile devices is more, that is good. And over here only the bounce rate is very less, that is on tablet. That is understood, because the traffic from the tablet itself is quite low. So I mean there is no question of bounce rate, so that definitely would be good. So this is what we can see from the device benchmarking. And then again we have a user flow related to benchmarking. So now over here we were talking previously about solving a problem which was related to the traffic, the bounce rate which we were getting from Vietnam and Indonesia, which was 100%, right? So now from here we can get to know that over here you can see Vietnam and Indonesia. We can see both the countries over here, And now if I increase, I'll just zoom it, then I can see over here. See how many 21 people came from Vietnam and they landed on this particular page, that is on the blogs page. They launched on the blog page, and then from the blog page itself, you can see 74.7% of the traffic have dropped off. So it means that they have exited the website, they have closed the website. So we get to know that, okay, fine, the total number of people who have come on the blog page, out of that, that 74% have dropped down. So these all arrows that we are seeing, we get to see that how many people are coming from different companies, different countries, and going to which pages of our website. Then from this web, this pages, the number of people who are remaining on these pages, some of them might go to this page, some of them might go to this page, some of them might go to this page, like this. So it doesn't mean that if there are 10 people on the same page, they all will click on the same link. They all will click on the different link that they feel, their mind will tell them that, okay, fine, you have to click this, you have to click this, this is your interesting thing, so click on this. So I mean, people might click on anything, whatever it is. So that is what we can see over here. So different pages that people are browsing, then they are going to other place, other web pages, and from there again some of the people are dropping off. See, from here they went over here, then say total there were how many people, say there were 13 drop-offs. See, out of 22 people who came over here, 13 people dropped off. So out of say 22 people, after dropping 13 people, the rest of them again separated through on different pages that we can see over here. Some of them went to these pages, some of them went to these pages. So like this, this is basically the traveling history of the web people on our website. From which country that person came, then on which page did he land on our website, then from that page which all websites did he browse, and then from which page did he exit our website. So that is the user flow of the people coming in from our website to and then exiting. So that is what we can see over here. So here we can see the total number, and last we might see whatever number of people we have seen. So one person was remaining over here, one session and one drop off, and then we could see that one person, the final person who was there on the website, dropped off. So that is what we can see over here. And yes, so this is what the user flow is. So from this report we get to know that if I just select the country Vietnam, and if I just select the country particular country, say like Indonesia, then I could get all the information related to this. So if I just say highlight traffic through here, so if I then I'll just get to see only Vietnam, only Vietnam is highlighted. So now you can see we had seen 100% bounce report. So here we can see Vietnam, say so many people came, so 178 sessions, so that is 178 sessions browsers opened, and out of 178, 156 people dropped off, and the remaining went to other pages. So most of them dropped off. So here the main reason is that they did not go to other pages of the blog. So that's what we can see over here. And the some of the people, three people over here, so three people went to this particular pages. So if I want to know that which pages did they go, so then I can even get to know that this person, after traveling through so many pages, where did he go, which all pages did he browse. So that all information I can see over here. So you can just see these are the pages and categories that person visited. So like this I can find out any information that I want. So for all the pages and all the people coming from different countries, So this is the user flow. So I can combine various pieces of information about Indonesia, then Vietnam, and then I can find out that why people are not liking these pages, and then I can come out to some conclusion that okay, fine, these people are never interested in these kind of things. So I mean, it's useless to waste time on these countries. So we should concentrate more on the countries where people are coming the most on our website. So that's what we need to follow. So that was all about the user flow report, which was into audience report. So we have seen audience report, and now we have acquisition report, behavior report, and conversion report. So let us see with start with the acquisition report. So I'll just go to overview acquisition report. So this is acquisition report where we can see that the different channels through which we have gained traffic on our website. So this is the direct, so that is the people who knew our website URL and they came on our website. Then these are organic search results, so people who were searching on Google with our keywords and found our website and came to our website. And then these are referrals. So referrals and social is basically the off-page SEO that we were doing, and we were putting our links and content on social media websites and referring on other social bookmarking websites. So from there we are getting all these traffics, and how many pages did they browse, that all information we can see. And over here the total number of users and the total number of browsers or tabs, and then we can see the total number of pages visited per session. So that all information we can see over here in overview. Then we see all traffic. So all traffic, again we get to see the channels. So again we will see the same report. I'm not sure why Google has provided this information again and again over here. This is related to all channels, see direct, organic, referral and social. So again this is the same thing over here, only the difference is the chart, that is the graph. So this is the line graph that they have provided, and over here we can see the pie chart. So this is what we can see over here. Again this is the same thing, 135, 6, 3 and 1. So here also if I click, is the it would be the same thing, I believe. See 135, 6, 3 and 1, so it's the same thing. So that's what it is. Then tree maps, again in tree maps only the user interface is different. Over here we have this kind of report, so this is all direct. So here we have, this is low traffic and this is the high traffic. So we got high traffic from organic search and referrals. The rest of them were direct traffic and social traffic. So that was only just with the help of one query. So that's what we can see. So again it's the same thing, 135, 6, 3 and 1. Then source and medium. So source and medium over here, now we can get to know that see we are doing off-page SEO. So now we will get detailed information about the places where we are doing off-page SEO and what is performing, from where people are coming with the help of those off-page SEOs. So you might have done off-page SEO on 50 websites. So now over here in this report we will get to know that okay fine, over here direct people, so many people have come. Now Google organic, so that is the people who have searched for our keywords on Google and they have clicked on our website URL and have come on our website, that is through Google. So this is the same thing which we had seen in the real-time reports when I had opened my website, this Google My Business application, and from there on the website button I had clicked and we came on the website and it showed Google organic. So that is Google organic, the traffic that we are getting from Google. Then this is one of the website, this is referral SendGrid, send it blue. Okay, so yeah, this is one of the website from where people came. So this is a referral website, so I got one user from this particular website. Then one user from, this is 10k hits, this is again web, referral website. Then from mobilefacebook.com, so that is again a referral website, one person from there. And this is from directly from our website, this is from CDN. Okay, so this is from content delivery network. So I mean that is from the cloud network we are getting. So the site is hosted on the cloud network. So from different page, different places the website is being accessed. So that we can see over here. So this is one of the websites, cdn.ampproject.org. So this is a referral website. From there we got one user. So like this we get to know that in source and medium, so under acquisition, under source and medium, we get to see all the off-page traffic, whatever promotions we have done. We get to see that which promotions are performing, which promotions are not performing. So if we get to know that, okay, if some performance, if some of the websites are not performing, then it's waste of time to put our time over there. So we need to say check again, and we need to do more promotion over there. So that is source and medium. Then we have referrals. So again over here I'll get to know all the websites which were referrals. So over here these are the referrals from where we got this much traffic. Then this is Google Ads. So we have a separate module for Google Ads. So basically this is for the paid advertising. If we have done any paid advertising, then it will show over here. So in the month, in this past 1 week, I haven't done any paid advertising, so everything would be blank. So Google Ads is not done. We haven't I haven't done any paid advertising I mean since lockdown has started. So from definitely from January, no paid ads were done on Google. So that was that is related to Google Ads. See, if you are using same Gmail address, then you will get all in the information from different modules. So you get information from Search Console, you get information from Google Ads. So that is the reason. See, Search Console information also we get over here. In Search Console we got to know that how many people are coming, how many, what is the traffic over here. So here in Search Console it will show us the landing pages. So landing pages of the on which the people are landing on our website through different source or medium, they are coming on our website. So here we can see these are all tags that we are seeing on my website. So these are tags where people landed. Then this is one of the blogs. So this is again a tag. Okay, so these are all the tags, most of them are tags. So they might have launched on different places and they have come on our website. So basically landing pages is where people land on our website from any source or medium. So that is landing pages. Then from which countries? So we already saw countries from Google report, from audience report we have already seen. So this is the country report, and then this is the device report which we have already seen. So I would not recommend using the Search Console report. I would suggest you to use audience report, because in Search Console what happens that sometimes if your web server is down, then in that case that information is not calculated. But the information what you can see over here in analytics is 100% accurate. So any which ways, if you want, you can match those reports and you can just check that what is the difference between both of them. You can open Search Console, you can open Google Analytics, that audience report, and you can just test both of them that why this variation is coming up. So that all information you will definitely get. Then these are the queries, that is the search terms that people are searching on the website and coming on to our website. So it's loading. So over here you can see advanced SEO interview questions, then advanced SEO interview questions and answers, advanced SEO questions, content targeting analytics, then content writing courses in Mumbai, then crowd boosters, graphic design courses in Navi Mumbai, a LinkedIn marketing tool, then Little Bird online marketing, then SEO interview questions 2019. So these are basically the different queries that people are trying to search on Google, and from there we our website have come up in search results. We can see all the impressions with different keywords. So with this impression we got 37 impressions, with this keyword we got 3 impressions, with this keyword we got 3 impressions. So like this, with different keywords that people are searching, we got different impressions. Our website came that many times, so impression is basically that many times the website came up in the search results. So that is what we can see. If I click on more date range and more results, then we might see. So actually currently there are only 13 results which we can see. So there are only 3 more results, so 3 more keywords which are listed over here. So that is all the search queries, so people who are searching on Google. So now let us see the next report, which is related to social. So then this is overview of social. So here we get to know that how much traffic we are getting through social media, what is the value of social value of our website. So we get to see that there are 178 sessions and one social referral, and conversions were 179 and contributed social conversion 1. So out of 178 sessions, one conversion was done, and out of 179 conversions on the website, so 179 conversion is basically the people the people who came on the website and they registered for newsletters or registered for affiliate marketing on the website, and various other things, same like visiting the two pages which I had added, those two pages, and plus contact us form. So out of all those events that we had set, all the goals that we had set, so out of all those goals, social media has helped us to convert only one conversion. So that is what the report is showing over here, and that was helped by Facebook. So the traffic of that person who came and converted on our website was through Facebook. Then what was the shared URL? So this was the URL on which the people came. So it was one session and this was the URL. And then if there was any social plugin used, that is social network, so no, we did not use any social network, so there is no information about this, so we did not use any plugin, so that's okay. So then network platforms, so what is the network platforms? Only Facebook is the network platform through which we gained the we are gaining the results, and we are getting some positive results. So at least over here in one session we got one page view and we got one conversion, and the landing pages through social media. So on this particular page, so over here we can see FBCLID. So wherever you find FBCLID, it means that Facebook client ID. So this particular traffic has come through Facebook. When people have clicked on any link of our website from Facebook, then you will see this particular this kind of URL, where in the URL you will find that it will be written as FBCLID, which is Facebook client ID. So that is what it is. Then finally we have something called as conversions. So through Facebook we had one conversion which we have already seen, and this is the date. So that was, I believe, on 2nd August. Yes, so 2nd August. So when was that 2nd August? Yes, yesterday, day before yesterday. Yes, so that was conversions. And then plugins, we do not have any plugins related to social, so that page is empty. And again the user flow, so this user flow what we had seen from countries, so this is the same thing which over here we are seeing from social network. So this is from Facebook, one user, and where did that person land? So that person landed on this particular page that was marketing tips. So I had shared this post on Facebook, and one person came from Facebook. So that is what it is showing. So here, this is the only explorer. So there is nothing ahead. So after seeing that one page, that person dropped off. That's it. So that was user flow report. And then under campaigns, so these are all paid campaigns and paid keywords. So since we haven't done any paid campaigns, so it will not show anything. Everything would be 0 0, no organic keywords, no cost analysis, no paid keywords, everything would be 0. So okay, this is organic keywords. So organic keyword is not provided, so organic keywords are not provided over here. And then cost analysis, so cost analysis also won't be there, so because we haven't done anything. So we just need to see over here, this report is a new report which we just need to get started. So that was the last report which was related to acquisition. So yes, this report we will see next time, this cost data import. So actually, if we have done some cost analysis, if we have done some paid advertising, then we can use this report. But right now, since we haven't done anything in this year, there won't be data available for this year. And this is something new which was just introduced, and this kind of page comes up only when the beta program turns to production. So this is cost import data. So this once we do paid promotion, it will come into consideration, and then it will show us more information. So what we can do is, we have already seen three reports, and next week we will see the remaining two reports, which is on behavior and conversion. So after these two reports are done, we would start with Google AdWords, so that is paid advertisement. So from there, once we complete that Google AdWords, then our social media would start. So our all basic modules and tools related to search engine optimization and all Google modules are completed. So now we would be starting with after that we would be starting with this social media. But yes, I mean still it is a long way, because Google AdWords might take 2 to 3 days. So let's see. So because we still have these two reports also, I don't think these two reports are quite big, because okay, over here it's very small. I mean, that's fine, so we can do this. And conversions, I mean conversion, okay, we just have goals. And e-commerce, we'll see e-commerce also. And multi-channel funnels, okay, that's fine. So I mean, this won't take much time, so maybe maximum around 20 minutes, 20 to 25 minutes, or maximum and half an hour it will take to complete this report. And the remaining time we will take it for Google AdWords. So next Monday and Tuesday we would complete this Google Analytics, and Google AdWords would be completed. Then from next to next week we will start with social media. So we are almost at the half, almost half, I don't say exactly half, but after completion of Google AdWords, I can say we would have completed half of the digital marketing course. So yes, so if you have any questions, you can let me know.
You have that tracing idea.
Sorry?
In the beginning, you have that tracing idea.
Your voice is not clear.
Hello?
Yeah.
In the beginning, you had a tracing ID and a Google code. So
yes.
Where do we have to take?
Yeah, see, for that you need to download a plugin from WordPress, and to make it very simple, you just need to install a plugin for Google Analytics. So with that Google Analytics, it will ask you to start the Visa to configure your this Google Analytics account. So once you get started, it will ask you to log in with your Gmail account, and once you log in with your Gmail account, it will give you one code which you will copy and paste it in your WordPress website, and then it will get associated. So I mean that's very easy process. So I'll also send you a link for a YouTube video which you can just test that, so you can just see that. So I mean there are various methods with which you can connect your website with Google Analytics. You can even paste that code in the header file of your website, that is WordPress website. So even that can be done. So that is also possible. So we will discuss that we will discuss that more on next week on Monday. We will discuss more on that. I will show you everything in detail. I will remove one or two websites from Google Analytics. I will again add them, and I will show you to you again in very simple format that what is the integration process.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, okay, fine. Yeah, bye.
Goodbye, thank you.
Yeah.